You're watching WMAR 2 News.
Maryland has now passed 12,000 deaths from COVID. This morning's report from the State Health Department includes 47 more deaths. So far, 12,016 Marylanders have died from the virus. The state's positivity rate is also up, but only slightly today. It's now just below 28%. Several new testing sites open in our state today. There's one at Ripken Stadium in Harford County. It'll be open Monday through Saturday from 9 to 3. A state testing site also opened up at Johns Hopkins Bayview Medical Center. It will open every day from 8 to 2. And there's a new site in Baltimore County right there at the old Sears at the White Marsh Mall. It'll be open Monday, Wednesday, and Fridays from 9 to 1. A reminder, Baltimore County testing clinics have now moved to appointment-based testing. You can find information on scheduling on our website, WMAR2news.com/coronavirus. A Maryland man is recovering after he successfully received a heart transplant from a pig. His name is David Bennett, and he was suffering from a terminal heart disease and has had to have surgery to save his life. The University of Maryland Medicine says the 57-year-old's medical history made him ineligible for a human heart or a heart pump. The FDA gave emergency authorization for the surgery on New Year's Eve, marking the first time that a full pig's heart has been used. It was genetically modified to remove three genes from the donor's pig that are responsible for rejection. And a second viewing for a Baltimore police officer who died after being shot in her patrol car happened tonight. Officer Kiana Holly was shot last month while on duty in the Curtis Bay neighborhood. She died a week later after being taken off of life support. She was 39, a mother of four. She joined the city police department just 2 years ago at the age of 37. And today's viewing that stopped at 8 o'clock at Wiley Funeral Home off of North Mount Street. Officer Holly's funeral is tomorrow morning at the Baltimore Convention Center. Drivers can expect heavy traffic downtown tomorrow morning and afternoon. Traffic modifications will be in place, including lane and street closures.
And now from WMAR 2 News, Maryland's most accurate forecast.
I'm tracking the coldest air of the season, but more importantly, the coldest air that we have seen in nearly 3 years moving in for the afternoon tomorrow. We'll start off the day in the teens with wind chills in the single digits, and temperatures only top out in the upper 20s across all of the state, and even colder numbers near the Mason-Dixon line, remembering that those wind chills will only top out in the teens. It's going to be a bitterly cold day, but we get back closer to seasonal as we head towards Wednesday, mid-40s for Thursday, staying dry for the work week, but a chance of a few flurries trickles back in on Saturday.
All right, click with us online at WMAR2news.com for updates on top stories and breaking news. Also for news and weather, while you're on the go, download the WMAR2 News app in the App Store. Thanks for watching. I'm Jamie Costello.